In this video, we will describe what a breakdown is when used in performance analytics, and how to create a breakdown. So what are breakdowns? Breakdowns are filters that we can use to focus more in-depth on a particular variable. By applying a breakdown to an indicator, we can refine our analysis and focus on a particular aspect of our indicator. Examples of some breakdowns are the default breakdowns provided in incident management: age, assignment group, category, priority, and state. In the last video in this series, we created data collection jobs to populate an indicator, and we looked at the data in the scorecard for this indicator, number of new HR cases, to see the data. On the chart tab, we see the data for this indicator. In the breakdowns tab, we can view the data filtered by category, department, priority, or state. We would like to see another breakdown of this data by HR group. To view the number of new HR cases by HR group, we'll need to create a new breakdown. But first, let's create the breakdown source. We need to define a facts table that will pull the breakdown source elements from the database. Since we want to see user groups, we'll select the SIS user group table. We want to point to the ID field in that table, so we select SIS ID. Now we need to set some conditions. Otherwise, the source will return all group IDs within the table, as we can see when we click the link to the records that match the conditions. Back in the breakdown source form, we want the source to only return active groups that start with HR. After we save the new breakdown source, we can verify that we specified the correct conditions by looking at the records that match the conditions. Here we can see that all of the records are active and start with HR, so we specified the correct conditions. Now let's create the breakdown. We need to indicate what type of breakdown this is, automated or manual. A manual breakdown is a list of elements not based on an automated breakdown source. So if we did not have a source table to populate the values for the breakdown, we could create the breakdown list here. An automated breakdown relies on a breakdown source and points to a field in a facts table or a scripted. In this case, we'll choose the breakdown source and save the new breakdown. Now we can go back into the breakdown we just created to set up a breakdown mapping. In this case, we want to define a relationship between the HR case table, the indicator source, and the group table, or SIS user group, which is the breakdown source table. We can select a field from the table, which we'll do here, or provide a script. We define this relationship so that when an indicator is associated with the breakdown knows which field value to use from the indicator to categorize the data. Now we'll populate the list of indicators by selecting one or more indicators that will use this breakdown. In this case, we'll just select our number of new HR cases indicator, but we could add more later. Next, we add the new HR group breakdown to the list of breakdowns for our indicator. Now that we have our breakdown set up, we'll need to run the HR data collection job again in order to populate the data in the breakdown. Let's look at the scorecard to make sure the breakdown displays. And here's the breakdown by HR group. In the next video in this series, we will show you how to create your first dashboard. For more information, please consult our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.